Hello everyone, this is Noor. Welcome back to my channel. I am here with another tutorial for you guys, and this is another tutorial using Beauty Color palette from Jeffree Star. I've been having this palette for so long, and yes, I still have the box because I want to do a haul video talking about this palette. This is my second look creating something using the palette, and I'm really happy about it. This is a look a little bit more on the dramatic side, and I love it. I wanted to use the pink in the palette for so long. Finally got the chance to, and I did it a little bit more dramatic, and I absolutely love my eyes, you guys. I'm living, okay? Living for this look. It's super pretty. And the highlight though, slay. If you guys would like to know how I created this tutorial, please keep on watching. So I thought to start off this tutorial from face and then moving on to the eyes. I think would be really fun. Sorry, I had something in my eye. So I just added a little bit of the dramatically different moisturizing lotion from Clinique. I have a sample of it. I mean, I've been putting it before I go to sleep, and is that a pimple? Sorry, I'm like super faced traumatized after what happened to me. The first thing I gotta start off, like I said in one of my videos, that I'm not gonna be supporting MAC Cosmetics anymore. I do have some MAC stuff here with me just because I have them. I just want to finish them and then go buy myself new ones. So that is what it is. So I'm gonna start off with my concealer. I'm using MAC Pro Longwear concealer. This is NW20 if you guys are curious, and I'm just gonna go ahead and apply that on my face. Since I had my skin problem, I haven't gotten anything like super high coverage, so I'm kind of excited today, I'm not gonna lie. Just taking sponge and I'm going to blend that out. So I really want the face to look super high coverage. I'm really excited to try the Tarte concealer. I mean, everybody's talking about that, and I really really want to give it a try. And if you guys recommend like a really good foundation, let me know. I found my Kat Von D Lock It Tattoo foundation. I tried it on my face yesterday and it seemed fine. I'm not putting it on today though. Oh, and I forgot to show you the update of my face. It's like everything's gone. There's like nothing left. Sorry about the light. Like, I have the worst lighting ever. Maybe if I close my curtain. I don't know, I just opened my Lightroom and it kind of seemed a bit better. So yeah, this is my skin now. There's nothing left. I'm super happy. I'm still taking the pills that the doctor recommended. The cream, I'm putting it only on my face now. So I just found like a little pimple that it needs to be hidden. And I tend to have redness just right here, like right on top of my brows. But just in the inner corners. Don't know why I have that redness right there. But I always had it. Which is weird. I'm just going to cover it up. For foundation, I'm going to be using... This is a sample that I'm just going to finish up. This is the Studio Fix Fluid Foundation from MAC in NC20. I'm so happy I washed my brushes. It gets cool when you have clean brushes. And I'm just going to place that all over my face. I really like this foundation. Like, it's gonna suck that I'm not gonna use it anymore, but I'm so sure there's something better out there. If you guys are wondering, I'm gonna start buying from Sephora. I wanna try different brands. Like, I've been using MAC since I started my channel, and I think it's fun to just try something new like that. I always have like new foundation application for you guys and like different brands rather than always using the same brand over and over. I swear, when you clean your brushes, your foundation coverage is like super nice. A lot of people use a beauty blender for their foundation, which is my next investment. I need to buy myself a beauty blender. I mean, I do have, but they're like super old and I don't know where they are. They're probably in my school train case that I got them when I was in school. I feel like doing a little bit of contouring. I think it would be fun. These that MAC have, I bought this from another store because we didn't have it anymore in the store I work in. This is the Quick Trick Stick. Softly does it and Titan Townie? Titan Townie. Don't know what that is. So I'm just gonna go ahead and contour with those. Pretty cool because they're like pencil. I'm gonna take my foundation brush and blend it out. I normally don't do cream contour, you guys, but for the sake for this video, I'll just do it. I'm gonna be putting my Kat Von D Shade and Light on top of this just to blend. I'm just gonna go ahead and highlight. I'm using MAC again, Prep and Prime highlight sticks in Light Boost and Bright Forecast. So this is Light Boost first. I use Bright Forecast to blend it out to kind of have more of an even I'm taking my sponge again and I'm just gonna blend it all out. I'm going to set my under eye. I'm using Kat Von D Shade and Light palette and I'm gonna use Levitation. I'm using the Sigma brush in P84. I'm just going to set my under eye. I love this powder, you guys. It's just so awesome. It's like instant highlight, like literally. I'm taking my Studio Fix powder. There's like basically none left in here. This is in C4. I'm taking my Shade and Light palette and I'm gonna finish up my contour. I'm using Shadow Play from Kat Von D Shade and Light. I'm just gonna contour on top of the cream. This is basically if you really like to contour and highlight, this is the perfect way to do it. So use cream first and then powder. Because people normally now, when they come and ask, oh, I want contour and highlight, you have to specify if they want cream and powder or just powder, because it's different. I'm just gonna take a little bit of Subconscious. I'm just gonna enhance a little bit more the contour. I can tell you, I really love the fact that I have clean brushes. I'm gonna go ahead and fill in my eyebrows. I'm gonna do this off camera because I've done a one-on-one eyebrows in my Get Ready video. If you guys wanna go ahead and check it out, it's on my channel. And I'll finish up one eye and I'll be back to show you the tutorial of the other eye. So I'm going to show you guys how I did this look. It's a little bit more dramatic and I love it. It's perfect if you want to go out and have some fun and get some drinks with friends and whatnot. It's so cool to do. You can also do it for Valentine's Day if ever you want, because there is a little bit of pink shadows in there. A little bit, it's like basically all over my crease. So the first thing I went ahead and I did is that I applied my MAC 24 Hour Eyeshadow Base all over my eyelid. And I'm using a Jeffree Star Killer Beauty Palette for this. I've been eyeing this pink to put on my eyes for so long, and I'm finally putting it. So the first color I'm going to be taking is called Star Power. This one right here. And I'm taking it with my MAC 224 brush. And I'm just going to apply this on my crease area. I'm starting with it lightly and then slowly building it up. It's a very high pigmented color, so I would probably tell you to be careful with it and not go super crazy with it at first. If you want to, you could. I mean, it's the perfect color to go crazy with. So I'm just going to apply that on my crease. I'm gonna try to wing it out as much as I could, because I want the shadows to go up like here. It's a very pretty neon pink color, by the way. Once I have that pink placed, I'm gonna go ahead and apply the gold color. It's called Rich Bitch. I almost dropped the palette. I had a heart attack. Literally, my heart literally stopped. I'm just gonna go ahead and wet my brush. I'm using a Coastal Scents little eyeshadow brush. Just wetting it a little bit with some Fix Plus. And I'm going to apply it in the inner corners of my eye and bringing it halfway. Now I'm taking a darker shade. I'm using Vanity, which is a very pretty, it's a very dark brown, but for some reason it turned black on me, because I mixed it a little bit with Black Rainbow, but it's a very dark color, you're guys gonna see. So again, start with it very lightly. Don't go crazy because it's super high pigmented. And I'm just gonna place it on the outer corners of my lid and bring it to the crease. And make sure that you blend it with Rich Bitch. I'm taking a small crease brush. This is MAC 224. I'm taking Star Power, which is the pink one, and I'm just gonna go ahead and start blending Vanity into Star Power. The trick for this look is to really have good blending to it and make sure that everything is kind of blended together. I'm gonna do the lower lash line right here because it's gonna be easier to finish up the eye. I'm taking Vanity and I'm taking it with a small little tapered brush. It's not really tapered, it's more like a smudger brush. I'm just gonna go ahead and apply Vanity on the lower lash line. I really also want to blend it out. If you guys don't know me, I love to have a smoked up lower lash line. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna come smoke it up with the pink. I'm gonna take Star Power with the 221 and blend it out. I'm just gonna smoke out a little bit Vanity on the lower lash line again, because I feel like I didn't do it that well. Just gonna go ahead and darken up a little bit Vanity into the outer crease. I'm gonna lightly start winging it out, the shadow, I'm just using the little blending brush. It's really easy to wing out the eyeshadow with this. And at the same time, I am blending it with Star Power. I'm taking the 224 brush and blending the rest of the eye out. I'm going to be taking Black Rainbow. It's a beautiful black shadow with a lot of rainbow glitters. I did not take a lot of this, just like a little bit, just to say that it's darker a little bit on the outer corners. And I'm going to blend it out. You want to make sure that you match it with the other eye as much as you can. It's very important. It's Jeffree Star's rules. I am living. It's so nice. To finish up the eye, I'm going to highlight the inner corners. I'm going to be using Princess right here with a small shadow brush and placing it into the inner corners of my eye, the tear duct area. I'm going to add black liner inside my eye. I'm using black chromographic liner, tight lining my eye as well. Gonna bring it to the tear duct. Now my eyes tend to be tearing up more lately. I just like to go ahead and use a waterproof liner, and I'm just going to do it on the inner corners of my eye, just to put a little bit there so my lash won't flick off. I'm gonna go ahead and apply lashes. This is a very wispy mix that I did. Sorry, I don't really remember what mix it is. I think they are lashes from MAC. They are 35 and 48 together. This is what it looks like. They're very nice. And I'll go ahead and apply that in mascara. And for mascara, I'm using a MAC mascara. This is the Twist Lash, and I'm mixing with the Insta Curl. So I'll go ahead and apply those, and I'll be back for the finished look. So rock my baby, rock my. I'm gonna rock you, rock my baby, don't you cry. Single mom, what are you doing out there? What I used on my face is I used, obviously you guys have seen me use the Kat Von D Shade and Light palette. I went over it a little bit just to kind of enhance a little bit more my contour. And then I used the Sleek Blush by 3 palette. I've had these for so long, I've never used them. I'm like trying to use them now. And this is Pink Sprint. Ow. And I used this color right here. This is called the Pink Parfait. Right here. These are pretty bright. I might use them in some other tutorials. But this one is such a nice color. And I applied it super, super lightly on the apples of my cheek. I did not go crazy with this. And then I used my favorite highlight palette ever. This is the Anastasia Beverly Hills in That Glow. And I just used one color. Excuse the dirtiness of this palette, okay? Don't judge me. I used Sunburst. This one right here. And I just used that to highlight because it gives like a nice whitish highlight going on. My light really sucks. So yeah, I just used that on my face. And then for lips, I went ahead and I mixed 2 of Jeffree Star's Velour Liquid Lips. I used Celebrity Skin, and then I mixed a little bit of Mannequin, just like in the center of the lip. And then I went ahead and I added some freckles. I really wanted to add a little bit of freckles. You barely can see them, but they're very, very lightly on my cheeks and a little bit on my nose. And I used the MAC Penultimate Brow Marker. What color is this? It's just one color, it's the brown. And they also have it in black, but that's the liquid liner. But this is the brow marker. I really hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. If you have any questions, just leave them all in the comments down below. I'll try to get you guys as soon as possible. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll talk to you later. Bye!